Hello everybody and welcome to Luxury Benefit Channel. My name is Sviatoslav and today we will talk about eyes movement for shifting distance, peripheral vision training, stick on windows exercise and eyes massage for better vision. Eyes movement for shifting distance. Move your gaze now into the distance. Now the tip of the finger that you need to keep at a distance of arm length from the face at eye level. This technique is already familiar to you, but it only partially resembles exercise for the third muscle group. In this case, refocusing on the gaze should occur easily and rhythmically without any tension and without obligatory fixation on the near and farthest point. The regularity of the pace and relaxed state of the eyes during exercise. I already said before that reading or watching phone or tablet at the same distance, which many people mistakenly do, is especially harmful for the eyes, causing a spasm of accommodation, and it's known to be a step for myopia. Therefore, it is not necessary to look exactly at the finger. Look into the distance as often as possible during any visual work on close distance. Make it a habit to shift your gaze and when walking, looking under legs, then on something in front, on top or sideways in the distance. Look at different objects outside the window and when traveling in transport, making sure that objects are located at different distances. However, the most important thing is to make a glance shift for yourself when reading and working at the computer. Place your PC on a table in front of a window or hang bright pictures on the walls. If there is no possibility to sit by the window, take your eyes off the screen as often as possible and switch your attention to the view outside the window or to the pictures on the walls. This will only have a positive effect on work productivity. Not speaking about the benefits for your eyes, they will become much less tired of visual work than before. Look straight and sides simultaneously for peripheral vision. Place two thumbs of both hands in front of you and slowly spread them apart while looking strictly in front of you, but keeping fingers visible. Gun your fingers, bring them together again, then dilute slowly. Repeat several times. Now bring your thumbs together in front of your eyes so that they lay on top of the other parallel to the floor right in front of you, the bridge of the nose. Raise one hand up and lower the other down. Spread your arms out while you see your fingers and while looking straight in front of yourself. Having reached the limit, bring your hands together and repeat everything, just change hands. In the next step, connect your thumbs diagonally in front of the bridge of the nose and spread your arms to the visible limit to the sides while looking straight. Bring your arms together and spread again. Do the same in the other diagonal plane. Now draw a circle clockwise with the finger of your right hand and counterclockwise, following the movement with your eyes. Twist finger in reverse direction and watch each eye with the appropriate hand. This exercise trains peripheral vision well and expands the visual fields, which are turned off from work when constant wearing of glasses or long-term work with the computer. You can shake your fingers to enhance the effect when spreading the fingers on both sides of the face, so that the eyes fix some movement on peripheral vision. However, in order not to look away, after the hands, find the object in front of you, keeping your grip on it and at the moment. For even greater effect, you can pick up burning candles or flashlights, which is especially useful in light or darkness. You can train peripheral vision in the process of daily activities. For example, when you are walking down the street or driving. While driving, strive to fix object with peripheral vision sailing past you on both sides. Or you can track something what is above or below. At the same time, you need to look directly, not moving the pupils. However, drivers probably use peripheral vision automatically. They need to follow the road all the time. Traffic lights. Track everything that happens from behind to the left and to the right of themselves. Exercise stick on a window. Stick on a window pane or draw at eye level a colored mark the size of a penny. Stand up or sit on a distance of 30 to 50 centimeters. It's approximately 12 to 20 inches from it, and alternately look at label, then on a remote object outside of the window. During performance of this exercise, fundamental importance here is a distant object. He must be in the area of blurry vision, which each person has their own. That is, a distant object should be located not as far away as possible, but at the distance from which you can see it, but not very clearly. It is very important to remember that during monotonous movement, gaze does not need to peer at a point or look at a distant object. The gaze moves calmly and effortlessly back and forth, fixing on the near and far points for about 2 seconds. At about the second minute of the exercise, the brain will understand that you are not challenging him to perceive something. The objects are the same, they do not need to choose a definition. As a result, nerve cells of the retinas and optic nerves relax, and you suddenly discover that you have begun to see a distant object brighter or completely distinctly. Be glad for your eyes and don't be surprised if glimpses of a clear vision will appear after exercise. This is how your vision gets better. Glimpses of clear vision will appear more and more often. Conclude, in a relaxed state, your eyes can see well, and if you're trying to squint, it leads to eyes tension and nullifies the possibilities of the eyes to relax and to see clear. Many people talk about the extreme usefulness of this exercise. Here's what one young man wrote about this exercise. I love the mark on glass exercise the most because my windows overlook to the beautiful place. True. I do this exercise is not 5 minutes, but longer, while I turn on the music, sway to the rhythm with the melody. And at the same stage, I begin to see clearly other buildings, trees and birds against a background of clouds. 3 fingers on the eyes massage. Press lightly with 3 fingers, index, middle and ring finger on closed eyelids for 3-4 seconds. Then loosen pressure. Repeat 3-4 times. You can strengthen this exercise while continuing to hold index and ring fingers on the outer and inner corners of the eyes. Lift your middle finger and slightly press it on the bone in the center of the eyebrow, more precisely above the pupil. Then bend your middle finger and press them on the center of the lower eye socket, located under the pupil. Do not use force. The pressure of the finger on the upper and the lower bone of the orbits should be light, as well as pressure on the outer and inner corners of the eyes with the index and middle fingers. Repeat this pressure several times, then place your middle finger back on your closed eyelids and lightly pat them with your fingertips. You can also slightly move your fingers from side to side, leading over the eyeballs. It's very important here to place your fingers correctly and understand the degree and the force of pressure of the eyes and eyelids. I believe that the corners of the eyes, how external and internal, you can push a little harder and very carefully on the eyeballs themselves. It happens that immediately after this exercise, a person sees more clearly. And it happens the other way around, the image is clouded. This may be due to both the condition of the cornea and excessive pressure, and with the state of intraocular liquids, since the circulation from pressure on the eye apples intensifies sediment rises from the bottom and the clarity temporarily worsening. Thanks for watching this video to the end. Today we learn about importance of shifting your look from phone or tablet to a distance as often as possible to avoid spasm. We learn about peripheral vision exercise, about stick on the window exercise, and about eyes massage for reducing eyes tension. Subscribe to my channel to learn more, and we'll see you again.